Welcome back to Sky Factory 3, another rainy day ahead of us, and today we're going to watch our infusion crystal be destroyed. It's gone. And we're watching this one not work. And do we know why? Yes, because all of these recipes have the wrong crystal in there. Let's see if we can change it. There's that one. Yep. There's that one. Aha, so I'm glad I came here to see this today. Otherwise, I would have been all stocked up with nowhere to go. There it goes. This one here. Same. Come here. Come here. Come here. Come here. Gotta chase it down. There we go. And of course that doesn't matter. So, good. Oop, I made a mistake. Let me get rid of this. Grab this. Make sure it goes interior and apply. There we go. Okay. Everything's back to normal. Now the crystal's working as it should. Alright. Nope, what I really came to do today was something not as spectacular. I want to get ready for that big massive machine over here to automate all my storage and items and things like that. But to do this, I need to get all my items from over here to over there. Well, I sat here and I started cleaning the stuff out, and that's going to be a monumental task. So I said, what might be easier? Okay, how about I pump it all into a couple ender chests and let the ender chest do the work? That's one way of doing it, and that's the way I'm going to do it. Never made one before, so we're going to try today. I didn't make one because I didn't have blaze rods, but now I probably have loads of blaze rods. We're just going to use white wool and things like that. So I'm going to need two chests. So 8 blaze rods, some obsidian, a couple chests, and some pearls. No problem. I'm pretty sure I have chests over here somewhere. I made like tons of them. Where are they? No, really, I made tons of them before. Maybe I used them all up. That is quite possible. Okay, we'll make some more chests real quick. With this mod pack, you can simply put raw oak wood in here to get your chest, so that's easy enough. We need blaze rods. I don't have any over there. Let's get some blaze rods. We'll just grab a stack because a stack of these guys. And we need what? Wool? Is that really it? Where is it? Obsidian and wool. Plain old wool. Okay. Now I think I actually have wool over here. Only need 2 pieces. So I'm sure I have 2 pieces. I have 14. That's all we need. I'm forgetting one thing. What am I forgetting? Obsidian. Okay. I need 4 obsidian. So we can grab it from this machine over here. Or we already have a stack. And of course we're making it automatically through the system here, which is pretty fast. As you can see. Much faster when I put the Ender IO stuff on there versus the original pipes we had before. Alright, so we're going to build 2 of these. 1, 2. Done. Alright. I'm not sure how we use them, so I think we just put them close together. And no, I think the color is all that matters. How do you break them? Will I get it back? Oh, okay. Well, that's interesting. Get this bad boy. And all we're going to do is break this up right here. Put this bad boy right there. And we're going to tell it to fill up. We're going to extract from here. Always active. We're going to insert here. And this thing should be filling up. Perfect. Oh, it could be a bit of time to do that, but that's okay. We have nothing but time. We're going to drop the ender chest right here, the other one. And we should see it filling up. Good. Perfect. I'm don't know if that's going to move properly in tiny piles. We'll have to see. We're going to extract always. That should fill up over here. And the tiny piles of glowstone. I don't have glowstones in one of those big machines, so I need to get one of these over here. Let's go ahead and grab this one. And let's make sure our glowstone... Oop, nope. Can't have that like that. Let's make sure there's nothing to increase the size. No, there isn't. Okay. This might go a little slower than we expected, but it's okay. Where's my key? Got a key? Good. We'll drop that there, and we'll lock it with glowstones in it. There we go. That's one down. And that's going to take quite a bit of time. So now we're going to get the next couple ones over here. Let's grab this one. They actually had an upgrade in it. It was a storage upgrade too. I remember those days. Alright, let's go ahead and move this to the close edge. And we'll add this one to here as well. Don't know what we're going to add to it. And lock it real quick. There we go. Go ahead and empty our inventory of things we don't need. And yeah, this is going to take quite a bit of time to function, but hopefully it will function properly. I kind of thought it would grab the bigger pieces versus the little nuggets, but I guess it's not going to do that. Most of this stuff over here will go. The things that don't go will have to move manually, which is not a big deal. I'm okay with that. We're going to move our furnace as well. We don't need it over here anymore. Take care of all these bits and pieces. There shouldn't be anything in the chest. There isn't. There we go. And we'll move the furnace over here as well. I don't know where we're going to put it yet. We'll just leave it over here for now. We have to do this special little pattern to get things set up for it. Okay, so that's that. And with my new helm, I can never tell if it's day or night anymore, so right now it's daytime. I guess I can look in the top right-hand corner. I want to use some more of these machines here to start making my cobblestone in a packs, in the big, the octuplet cobblestone, start compressing it completely. I can start using, I have a drawer controller, I have another. I thought I had another compacting drawer somewhere. I don't see it. We're just going to take it, this right here, put it right next to this chest, and just start sucking it out of this chest. We're going to disable this piece over here. We don't want to do anything with this. We want to extract, always, and we want to insert. There we go. Now we're going to get double compressed cobblestone. We're going to take that double compressed cobblestone and go to another one to make quadruple, then to another to make sextuple, another to make octuple. So we'll need to use filters for that as well, so we only grab the ones we want. In fact, we already have a double. So once some of these, more of these things free up, and I think I will need to move, this redstone will not move properly either. I don't have it going in the right drawer. Let me kind of speed this along some, because I don't want to sit here for even with this, it's still going to go slow. We can unlock this now. There we go. And we can grab this. All right, and we'll set this up right here next to it. And let's see if I have any filters left. I don't know if I do. I had filters earlier, but I don't see any in here. Wait, filter. Yes, we have a filter. Okay, great. So we're going to put this here like that. And we're going to do an item filter. Now, to get an item filter, I have to program it first. So let's see. To program it, I need to go here. Put the filter in there first. I only want, what is in here, soul sand? Okay, I only want that be going over. I'm going to extract it. And I'm going to insert it. Now this should be is putting double and it's making it into quadruple. Not bad. Now this is only one speed cobblestone generator. I mean, it's going to be super slow. We should have done this a long time ago and we didn't. Mistakes were made. The reason it's going so fast now is because I have a huge surplus of cobblestone in here. Let's go ahead and drop it all off. See if we can get a quadruple out of this. No, not even quite close. It's going to be a lot. Yep, and we're completely empty. Almost. It makes one every 2 seconds. So we will upgrade that to the highest level possible. Let me see how that works. I can't remember. It wasn't that bad though. At least not at our level. You have to go in order, so it's just all iron around that one, then all diamonds, then all blaze rod. That's why we stopped at diamonds. And then all emeralds. So we need 8 of each. So iron, diamond, blaze rods, emeralds. We can do that right now. Where's the iron at? Yeah, this is not even organized at all. There's the iron. Iron and diamonds are over here. All right, then we had blaze rods. And then we had emeralds, which were also over here. I think that was it, right? Iron, diamond, blaze rods, and emeralds. Okay. You know what? We're going to do the other one as well. Let's do in the furnace. It'll be 16, and then we'll need to get the emeralds as well. There we go. Okay. We'll upgrade this one first. To super ludicrous speeds, so put that in there. We'll put the iron around it. Phase one. Well, actually phase three. Phase four. And then the last one is this one. Here we go. One cobblestone every tick. Okay. Emerald. Let's see how fast this thing goes. It's almost going faster than my IO can keep up with, which is great. We need that. Okay, so is it faster than this? Looks like it keeps one there at all times. Yep, okay, so that's going to go a lot faster. Then we'll take this one down. And we'll upgrade it as well. Crafting station over here somewhere? Of course not. Let's get this guy upgraded. Yeah, this should have been done a long time ago. What was killing me was I didn't have blaze rods. There we go. So with the super speed here, as well as the furnaces, with the uranium underneath them, this is going to fly. Now this should be set up already. Extract without signal. Okay, great. Now I have all this cobblestone on me. Let's go ahead and just put it in a box because we don't care about no one's feelings but our own. Yeah, this is still going pretty slow. What? How come it's... Oh, it's doing glowstone now. Okay. Well, no, it's been doing glowstone. I pulled out gold, didn't I? That's right. Grab all the goldstone. Put that in here. Ooh, not the chest. Is that it for glowstone? Yes. Let's put this back where it needs to be. A double compress needs to be over here. Put it right there and it should suck it out. Good. Alright, and this needs to be relieved at the key entry. What's left? Why is it still doing that? It's empty. I think it's just stuck with a key pattern in there. There we go. Okay. And we'll put this over here as well. And we'll lock it. There we go. How's our ender chest over here doing? Man, I think it's full. Let's stop it. Stone? Okay, we can't have stone. Why are the diamonds filling up? Oh, because they're looking for the other thing. Okay, no problem. Let's grab the diamonds out of here. And we'll put these in this box up here. Where I can't reach from the ground, of course. Not a good thing. Now the diamonds are being fed out. The gold should go where it belongs. The glowstone should go, but the clay won't. Now, I thought I had a place for clay. We do. The clay should be going. Can it just not keep up? Is there something else? Is this chest not too full? Oh, it's the chest. So the glowstone has nowhere to go. I wonder why it doesn't. It should be going right here. Interesting. Something's causing it to clog up. I'm not sure what that would be. Must be just all the stuff coming through here. It's gotta be. I just may have overloaded it. We have emeralds in here as well. We'll put emeralds in one over there too. Looks good. Block of emeralds. Okay. Dirt, I don't know if dirt has anywhere to go. I don't think I made a place for dirt anywhere. I do, but it's probably full. It's getting there. Okay. So we're just gonna have to go back and forth with this, kind of rocking and rolling, babysitting this system until it can do what it needs to do. I don't know why this clay is stuck in here. Shouldn't be, nor the glowstone. It should all be going, all be flowing. Oh, it's stuck because this thing's full. Duh, okay. We just talked about that, didn't we? Alright, all the dirt is in there. Close enough. And we have stone we need to move now. And clay. I don't know why the clay didn't go. Let's check it over here. Yep, everything else is going to move once this drawer lets it. It just can't keep up. I got too much stuff coming through here. Now let's make sure my dirt form is still working. Yes, it is. This is still functioning. Which means that these eggs should leave here in a few moments. Well, we'll just let it do its thing. Things are backing up, but these nesting pens also have plenty of overflow. Just not sure if it's going to keep up with the added demand of that ender chest tripping out over here. What we'll do is we'll turn this off for now, I think. Just disable it. Has a chance to catch up, because there's a lot of materials over here. That may not be the smartest decision to do that, but I really want all my items over here prior to getting the refined storage system. These guys I don't have a spot for. I know that for a fact. We'll put these over here, and they have plenty of room for those. Of course, I don't think I have chickens dropping prosperity shards, which means I'm going to need them, I think, for other items. And you can't make them, I don't think. So I will need to get my grinders back on. Yeah, you only get my sieving, so... not going to be good. I thought I had chickens making those, but no, they don't make prosperity shards. Unfortunately, I'm not using a lot up anymore now that my farm is automated over there with that master infusion crystal. And that was causing a lot of damage. Alright, what else can we do? Ender chest didn't take long at all. We got this thing cranking out max speed. How is this working? I still don't even have quadruple. I mean, I may have to make quite a bit of these tier 5s. Let's check our achievement book out. We've unlocked a few achievements. Oh, we haven't done as many as I think I have. Let's see. We haven't crafted these seeds yet. I don't really see a reason to. Because I have the chickens doing the job. We did do the Master Infusion Crystal. We did do the Supremium Apple and the Supremium Armor. We have Flied. Blue. Use an angel block in your ability to start a new island somewhere else. Use your angel block in your ability to... Huh. Haven't done that yet. Travel the bottom of the earth using a boat. Yeah, we'll do it naked because I've never seen anyone survive that yet. We haven't done that. Kill a wither, definitely. We have not been to the inn yet. Don't even know what the end city is. We haven't used SAG. Energy conduits to power several machines at once. I'm pretty sure we've done that. Is this energy conduit? Yeah, we've done that. I don't know if we didn't mark it off sooner. Nope. Link an Ender pouch to an Ender chest. Alright, let's do that now. Ender pouch. Never made one of these. We're gonna go with white. So blaze powder, leather, ender pearl. Alright, blaze powder. 1, 2, 3, 4. Do I have leather over here somewhere? I probably don't. Let's go grab it from over here. Leather. How much leather was it? 3 leather and 1 wool. 1, 2, 3. Ender pearl. Again, 1 wool as always. Did I grab it? I did. Okay, let's build it. Whoa, this flying is off the chain. Ender pouch. Good. Alright, right now it's linked to... Oh, it's already linked. Nice. Cool. Alright, that was easy. Let us checkmark that box and then refined storage. Yes, 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 I know. Looks like that's where we're at. What else? We may have done some things over here. Craft a melee tinker's weapon. No, we did not do tinkers. We built... the frickin' Supremium, which is why we can't level it up and stuff. Yeah. None of this stuff. We haven't crafted the Petal Apothecary yet. Or we can do this later. Looks like. Draconic, I have no idea what that even is. Oh, okay. We're working on this right here. That's why I started that process with the cobblestone generators. Let's go back. You know what? We could technically do the Petal Apothecary right now, I think. Let me see what that takes. I mean, we're going to need to kill Gaia eventually, so... Wasn't that hard, I don't believe. Cobblestone, a slab, and a... Yeah, okay. All stuff we should have easily lying around. I don't see slabs in here. How about in here? Really? Did I put it all away? Alright, 2 slabs. 5 cobblestone. And a feather. I don't know if it matters what color it is. We'll grab a white one because we're already... That's what the picture said. Make this bad boy. Boom and boom. We can check that off. we'll place it right here. Just because, it doesn't really matter. We can move it later. We want to add water to it, so it's always filling up. We'll probably use Pam's kitchen sink for that. Hopefully it works. Boom. Pure daisy? Maybe. What does that take? It wasn't that hard, I don't think. It's just 5 white petals. Okay. I mean, 4 white petals and a seed. Okay. I remember the seed part. We're going to move this to the water. Or maybe I can put it next to that sink. I hope the sink will fill it up. Oh, what is this? The transfer node fluids? Let's take a look at that. Yeah, I forgot how to use these. I'm thinking if I just put this right here. It does not work that way. Okay. What if it's below it? Would it work below it? Try. If it works, will it? Nope, doesn't work that way either. Okay, worth a shot. Close this back up. Where'd it go? I'm missing one. Is it because I broke a half slabs while I did that? I bet you it is. Do I have any more cobblestone? I do. Okay, that's ugly, but who cares? Alright, so we got this. We'll just run it over here instead. Where's my water source? Right about here. So like we did before, we'll just put it right by the water source. And I'm still flying. We'll grab a bucket. We'll grab some flowers. How many do I have? I'm down to quite very few. I'm gonna grab 16. I'll remember to plant some later. And we need 4 seeds. All right, let's go grab a bucket. Might as well get some of this stuff knocked out while we have some time. This is all the easy stuff anyway. I know how to do this because of regrowth. That's the only reason I'm like, yeah, let's do this. Alright, so that's filled up with water. Let's empty our inventory. You'll see why. So we'll go 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And I should be able to do this, this, and right click with empty. There we go. So if you right click with an empty inventory, it puts in the last recipe it did. So it kind of knows it, which is kind of cool. Instead of doing everything else the hard way. All right, there we go. Got 4 flowers. Now with the 4 flowers, does it say I need to do anything with it or just make it? Create 64 Livingwood and 64 Living Rock. Okay. Well, we need cobblestone. 64 cobblestone. And we don't have any over here anymore. Gotta be careful, I'm running out of cobblestone now because I don't have it. Like, I'm so used to having 3 to 4 a whole chest full on demand. Alright, where's my oven? Here it is. Put that there, there, and I think 1 will be enough. Let's see, let's watch. No, so close. Oh well, 64. All right. Now living wood is just regular wood pieces. Let's check our crate here. How's it doing? It's still quite full, and nothing's going down. Something's not right. Oh, this is just completely full. has nowhere to go. I have any more void upgrades? I don't. Let me grab a void upgrade. Alright, that's the problem. I have nowhere for the dirt to go. Alright, we'll just tell it to go here. Until we have a better way of doing this. There we go. That'll give me quite a few more stacks. This should fill up. Why is it not filling up? There should be tons of eggs. And it's got so much to catch up on. Yeah, we need to get a void upgrade. I have a void. I think I may have used them all over there. Let's go look in my chest. Did I put any? Oh, there they are. Okay. So we're going to void out any more dirt. There we go. Hopefully it keeps filling up, and then when it gets full, it stops. Anything else we need to void out? The manure is being voided eventually. I think the rest is being voided. We don't want to void the eggs because we want the eggs to go all the way over there for now. Made the dirt. I could technically turn the compost off, but then I would need tons more void upgrades. Let's grab this wood. We need a total of 64 wood. Okay. Where's the wood? Right here. 64. And we also need three diamonds. 1, 2, 3. Do we have sticks? No. One more wood. All right. Like that. Like that. And we're making a, you guessed it, an axe to chop this wood down. All right. So first things first. I guess over here is good. We'll just do a row like this. And we're gonna do a row like this. I don't know where the centerpiece is. That's the center there. There's one. Another one. Center there. A flower. And another one. Center there. A flower. And the last one goes here. That should be 32 wood total. Yes. Okay, we did that right. With a flower grow, it will not grow unless it's on dirt. Okay, well, let's grab some dirt. Like, we don't have plenty of dirt. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4. And where's my pickaxe at? Knock this piece out. And put dirt down. There we go. Knock it out. Dirt. I'm not sure what your knowledge level is of Botania, but this is the basic Botania that you learn when you do regrowth, if you ever play regrowth. There we go. You can tell it's working by the sparklies. This is going to make living wood. It only takes about a minute. We're going to take a quick break while this is happening. Next 30, 45 seconds. Thought I'd be done by now, but it's not. All the sparklies. And we should be able to vein mine this. Or ore mine. It's been so long since I've done it. I forgot the terminology. Come on. There it goes. It's now converting. And then we'll ore mine this. Boom. I missed doing that almost. These guys done. These done. Doesn't take long. We have four flowers. Doesn't take long at all. And then we'll do the stone next, and I'll probably need another pickaxe, it looks like. So let me grab two more diamonds. I should still have enough sticks, I do. Make another pickaxe. Here we go. We'll keep that from when this one goes away. We have 96 uses, plenty. We only need 64. Cobblestone does not work. It has to be a type of stone. I think andesite works and diorite, things like that. But cobblestone's a big fail. You know, we can probably upgrade our furnace to the ultimate furnace now. Ooh. Another star. We sure can. Let's go ahead and do that next. And then we'll call it a day. Last two. There we go. Oops, wrong button. It's tilde. Whoa. Getting aggressive with the sword. All right, we'll lay this down. Lay these down. You see how it's kind of sparkly? All right. This flying thing is kind of hard. All right, there we go. Let's go grab the skulls while we're thinking about it. We need four skulls. Quit flying. One, two, three, four. We need another star and the Supremium Essence blocks. Okay. I remember back when this was been like, it was, remember when this was unthinkable? Oh my God, four blocks of essence? There's no way we'll ever be able to do that. Yeah, then fast forward. Until now, another star should be in here. Yes, they are. All right, this is still smoking. Should be done shortly. Here we go. Living rock, so pretty. It's a great texture. Because I was so bad at laying it down, it's gonna be a few more moments for it all to finish. Come on, you can do it. Last one, there we go. All right, and we'll do the last 32 now. And we'll build the furnace while this is working. All right, there we go. The furnace requires the Supremium furnace to upgrade it. So actually it only has three of those blocks, not four. Go, get the furnace, drop that in there, and boom, ultimate furnace built. Of course we're gonna test it out, right? You know that, right? We did with stone last time with 64 cobblestone. Do I have cobblestone here at all? No, I don't. Let me grab some from here. There's 64. Let me grab a stack from over here. I'm thinking I can do like millions of it, but we'll see. I'm gonna try two stacks. Look at that. Look at that. That is ridiculous. That was just one little tiny mini coal. Yeah, it will do tons. That is just amazingly fast. So we can put that on an automated smelter system, and man, it will just fly through anything we want it to. And that's it. We have 64 of each. Let's go to our achievement book. And let's check that off. Create 64 living wood and 64 living rock with a pure daisy. We've done that. And the mana pool and mana spreader is actually quite easy too. The wand of the forest is quite easy. This here is a huge jump. I mean, a huge jump. We'll have to construct a whole situation where we have flowers generating mana, going to mana, the mana pools we built. The portal requires mana to maintain its on status. It's a huge jump. It's like we saw, we did basically, we crafted this. Let's pretend we did. That takes 1 minute. All this. This here will take another 5 minutes, maybe, at the most. This here, an hour or two to three, let's just say 5 hours, because you got to generate the mana as well. So this is not going to happen anytime this episode at all. That's okay. We're way ahead with the quest books that we should be. Technically, we should be going back to the basics. We're going to make the tinkers. We already made it. We're just going to actually use it. We're going to just put some stupid enchant on the seed mesh to mark that off. And then we're going to craft these seeds since we can now. It's so easy. Since we have the red supremium rolling in like candy. Mob chunks. We'll probably use this down in the nether. Get a mob chunk. Because the mobs are so prevalent down there right now. And the angel block. How much time do we have? We'll make an angel block. We can make an angel block right now. And then we'll call it a night. A-N-G-E-L. Angel block. It's just two feathers, obsidian, and gold ingot. Okay. And two feathers. One obsidian, which should be right here. And a gold ingot, which is over here. If you've never seen the angel block being used, it's pretty cool. Let's go ahead and craft this. Boom. And done. Look how easy that achievement was. And we have stone on us. We'll use stone. Why not? Basically, no matter where you go, you can put the angel block down anywhere. Just click where you want it. Boom. That's it. And now we can actually build off this angel block. So this is an easy way to make platforms. And you get it back. It goes right back to your inventory once you use it. So you can use it again and again and again. And meanwhile, the stone kind of seems to fall away, but that's really all there is to an angel block. So if you can do it sooner, if you're watching this before, you haven't really started playing yet, and you want to make huge platforms without doing the machines that build them for you automatically, make an angel block. The problem is you kind of got to be able to fly too to get it where you want it, you know? So that is one of the disadvantages. But once you can fly, you can put a platform anywhere if you don't want to use the builder tool that builds out in certain areas. We haven't really showed you that. There's a thing called a builder. You build this. It's actually not very expensive at all, as you can tell. You give it power. You put a template in there of what you want to build. And it will project it out in the distance somewhere, or even right above your head or below your feet. And it will build huge platforms. It can build domes. You just got to feed the materials that it needs, and it's done. It's pretty amazing. Did we check our angel block off? Nope, there we go. So that's it. This might be a little bit shorter episode than the rest. There wasn't a whole lot to show you. I'm going to do the inventory management off screen because that's just going to be slow and painful. Even with it doing the way it's doing it, I don't know why it's taking so long. God, I guess, what is that white stuff? Quartz? Oh, because I have nowhere to put quartz. This dirt is just not being made fast enough to eat the eggs up. I think I broke my system. Alright guys, well thanks for watching. We'll catch you next time, and keep the key alive. Take care, bye-bye.